In the late 1950s, the US Navy wanted a long-range interceptor with high endurance to defend its ships against sweep missiles and bombers. And for this reason, the F-14 was developed. F-14 was popular in its time and now, and one of the reasons was its variable wings. The wings of this fighter were designed to be agile and achieve high speeds and safe landing at low speed on the aircraft carrier. The 14's wing sweep can be varied between 20 degree and 68 degree in flight and can be automatically controlled by the central air data computer. Pilots can manually override the system if desired. When parked, the wings can be or sweep to 75 degree to overlap the horizontal stabilizers to save deck space aboard carriers. In an emergency, the F-14 can land with the wings fully sweep to 68 degrees. The wing pivot points are significantly spaced far apart. This has two benefits. The first is that weaponry can be fitted on a pylon on the fixed wing glove, liberating the wings from having swiveling pylons fitted. A future which had proven to add significant drag on the F-111B. When the wing is swept back, which allows the aircraft to reach the Mach 2.4 top speed. The body of the aircraft contributes significantly to overall lift, and so the Tomcat possesses lower wing loading than its wing ARRA vault suggests. When carrying hypersonic missiles or other heavy stores between the engines, this advantage is lost and maneuverability is reduced in those configurations. Ailerons are not fitted, which roll-controlled being provided by wing-mounted spoilers at low speed, which are disabled if the wing sweep angle exceeds 57 degrees. Full-span slats and flaps are used to increase lift bows for landing and combat, with slats being set at 17 degrees for landing and 7 degrees for combat, while flaps are set at 35 degrees for landing and 10 degrees for combat. An airbag fills up the space occupied by the sweep back wing when the wing is in the forward position, and the flexible fairing on top of the wing smooths out the shape transition between the fuselage and top wing area. The twin tail layout helps in maneuvers at high angle of attack while reducing the height of the aircraft to fit within the limited roof clearance of hangars aboard aircraft carriers. Two triangular shaped retractable surfaces called glove vanes were originally mounted in the forward part of the wing glove, and could be automatically extended by the flight control system at high Mach numbers. They were used to generate additional lift force ahead of the aircraft's center of gravity, thus helping to compensate for Mach drag at supersonic speeds. Automatically deployed at above Mach 1.4, they allowed the F-14 to pull 7.5G at Mach 2 and could be manually extended with wings swept full aft. They were later disabled. However, owing to their additional weight and complexity, and it was locked into place in the early versions and completely removed in the B and D versions. Okay guys, this video ends here. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching. Have some more related videos to suggest. I'd be happy to watch them. I hope to see you again in the next video.